गुड मॉर्निंग एवरी वन. माई सेल्फ शीला ओसमनी, लेक्चरर. आई गिव द इन्फॉर्मेशन अबाउट द थर्ड सेमेस्टर सब्जेक्ट फैब्रिक स्ट्रक्चर. सब्जेक्ट कोड इज 15FT3040. फर्स्ट यूनिट इज यार्न. टुडे सेशन इज सेवेंथ सेशन. यू आर ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द डेफिनेशन ऑफ द यार्न, इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ द यार्न, टाइप्स ऑफ द यार्न्स, डिटेल इन स्टडी ऑफ द सिंपल यार्न्स एंड द ply simple yarns. Under simple yarns you have studied four types of yarns, and novelty yarns, under novelty yarns you have studied about the seven yarns. Next, spinning. Yesterday session we have discussed about the spinning, what is spinning and the types of the spinning, and next dry spinning and the ring spinning and the mule spinning. Yesterday we have discussed. Today we are discussing about the wet spinning and the dry spinning. What is spinning? Spinning is a major part of the textile industry. So spinning is very important and the major part of the textile industry. From by the spinning you will get the yarn which is used for the production of the fabric or manufacturing of the fabric. So it is a major part of the textile industry. Spinning is the twisting together of drawn out strands of fibers to form yarn. So spinning is a nothing but the twisting of the strand fibers from the strands to get a continuous length. It is the drawing out, twisting and winding of fibers into a continuous thread or yarn. Types of spinning: wet spinning, dry spinning, ring spinning and the mule spinning. This is the process under which wet spinning is done. This is the coagulated solutions. Here the yarn. Here the this is the process. Spinneret is there. Through this the yarn is coagulated and then yarn is taken, drawn out and given spools. Wet spinning, the first commercially successfully method for the manufacture of man-made fiber was the wet spinning. It is the commercial method, first method, manufacture of man-made fiber. The process involves the use of an appropriate liquid solution which is pumped through a small nozzle, which is called a spinneret, into a chemical bath that coagulates the extruded solution of endless strands of filaments. In this process, what you are doing, you are getting involved the appropriate solution, liquid solution, which is pumped through a spinneret, through which a chemical bath coagulates the extruded solution of endless filaments. You will get the strands. These coagulated continuous fibers are drawn out of the bath, purified by washing, dried and then wound onto spools. So after coagulation takes place, if the fibers are drawn out of the bath and taken out from the bath and purified by washing, and that is removal of the some of the traces by washing and dried, then wound onto the spools. The construction of the spinneret may be varied according to the desired results. So spinneret, what the spinneret consists of? It consists of the nozzles or the holes depending upon the diameter and the numbers. The varies, the spinneret has many types, that is only one hole or the one nozzle, extruded nozzle, or many nozzle with the varying diameter. If the spinneret has one extrusion hole, then a monofilament yarn will be produced. If the spinneret has a one hole, that is monofilament, single filament, that is known as the monofilament yarn. If the spinneret has a many holes, that is the multifilament yarns will be produced. If the spinneret has a more than the one hole, that yarn is filament, yeah, multifilament yarn. But the size and the number of holes may be varied. So as earlier I told, spinneret has many holes. Depending on the diameter of the hole, the yarn will be produced, which is used for the many other purposes. The thickness of the yarn is determined by the number and size of the filaments of which it is constructed. So thickness is the yarn is determined by the number and the size of the filaments which the constructed. The amount of twist will affect the texture and the strength. So higher twist we get the different textures, and the even the strength also varies depending upon the amount of the twist given to that particular yarn. This is about the wet spinning. Next is the dry spinning. Dry spinning, monofilament and multifilament can be produced, and the diameter of the yarn depends upon the number and size of the spin rate holes. As the name indicates, earlier in the wet spinning also we had discussed, monofilament and the multifilament can be produced if the diameter of the yarn, that is the nozzle or the hole the which the spin rate has. The amount of the twist given to the yarn will determine its texture and the strength. The amount higher the twist, finer the yarn and smoother the yarn, and the strength will be more. In this way, the amount of twist given to the yarn determines the texture and the strength. In dry spinning, a volatile solvent is used to dissolve the raw materials and form a solution. That is, in dry spinning, volatile solvent is used, then the solution is purified by filter. What is the filter means? If it, separation of the residue and the solution. Then the solution is extruded through a spinneret into a warm air chamber where the solvent evaporates, solidifying the fine filaments. After the purification, that is by the filter, and we get the solution. This solution is extruded through the spinneret, that is passed through the spinneret into a warm air chamber. It is through the spinneret they are passed into the warm air chamber where the solvent evaporates, the liquid evaporates and solidifying the fine filaments. Finally, the filament yarn either is immediately wound onto bobbins or is further treated for certain desired characteristics or end use. So the filament yarn is either immediately wound onto the bobbins after the extrusion from the spinneret, and after the solidification of filaments, they are wounded on the bobbins, or they are taken to the further treatment processing for the end use. Dry spinning is used in the production of acetate, triacetate and some acrylic, modacrylic, spandex and vinyl fibers. So dry spinning is used for the production of acetate and triacetate, some of the acrylic and the spandex vinyl fibers. This is the process of the dry spinning. Here the warm air is passed, the process. Then this is the wet spinning. Here the coagulation takes place. After the coagulation, so then the evaporate solidification, then the yarn is extruded and wounded on the bobbins. Here the warm air is passed, which solidifies the filaments and wounded, extruded and wounded on the bobbins. This is the dry and this is the wet spinning process. So wet and the dry, here liquid solution, coagulating bath is there, here warm air chamber is there. So this is the wet and the dry spinning processes and the stages. After completion of this, you have to answer this multiple choice questions. If the spinneret has one extrusion hole, then a dash yarn will be produced. So already discussed about this. If the spinneret, depending on the number and the size of the spinneret, you are getting the filament yarn or the yarns. So first option is staple, second filament, C multifilament, D monofilament. So which is the staple? It is the short length fiber, not the filament. That is filament, it is a long length but not the yarn. Here C multifilament, here the one extrusion hole is there in the question, but here multi means many holes, so this is also a not correct answer. D monofilament, as the mono means a single, it has a one extrusion hole, so the yarn is multifilament yarn will be produced. Right answer is the D monofilament yarns will be produced if the spinneret has a one extrusion hole. Next, if the spinneret has many holes, the dash yarns will be produced. If earlier one hole, it is a monofilament yarns. In this question, if the many holes, if the spinneret has a many holes, then that yarn will be produced. which yarn we produced. First option is staple, second is the filament, third, that is C, is monofilament, and D, multifilament. In this staple, short length fiber it is, not the yarn. Here, means it is not a correct answer. Filament is also not correct answer. Monofilament, it mono as the name indicates, mono means single, one hole, but here many holes. So the right answer is the multifilament. So it has the many holes, we get the multifilament answer through the that spin rate. So right answer is multifilament, that is the option D. Next, for the assignment, you have to write the answers for this, that is describe wet spinning and explain dry spinning. You have to write the answers explanatory to the dry and the wet spinning. And the references, I have referred these books, and you can refer these books for the further detailed information and the clear information. These are the reference books. Thank you.